based off the production and improved skill they've shown off after just a few games, I'm about to be predicting the 10 most improved NBA players this season. You're going to find out every talent that's ready to take a massive leap forward, and in some cases, the all-star step, so stay tuned to see who's the NBA player that's most likely to significantly improve in 2021. If you're already subscribed, welcome back to D-Flow Hoops. If you're new here and a basketball fan interested in NBA rankings, predictions, and stories, you're definitely in the right place. Please subscribe and click the bell so you get notified every time I post content. That's at least twice a week. Shout out to Caleb for saying that the Spider D. Mitch is his favorite shooting guard. Going on to say that Donovan's a future MVP. Strong words right there, but stay tuned for the question for a chance to have your comment featured next video and to compete for yearly awards in Community Speaks. Just to be clear, this isn't a ranking, so these 10 are in no particular order, but again, I'll tell you my most likely MIP at some point. Number 10, Shake Milton. After being the 54th pick in the 2018 NBA Draft and spending the majority of his rookie year in the G League, Milton's sophomore campaign last year saw him become a key cog in the Sixers' rotation. Shake scored a career-best 39 points in a game last March, making 14 of his 20 shots from the field. In his playoff debut against the Celtics, he averaged just under 15 points on very solid efficiency. But it's how the 24-year-old looked in 2021 that leads me to believe he'll be one of the more improved talents this year. As the pick-and-roll ball handler, Shake's getting himself and his teammates extremely easy looks, almost like an elite player would. But what an incredible story it would be if a player who nearly went undrafted a few years ago ends up being the missing piece for a Philly team looking for production around Simmons and Embiid. Number 9. RJ Barrett. In 7 combined pre- and regular season games so far, New York's third overall selection from last year's draft is finally living up to the hype. RJ Barrett's looking way more under control, poised, and dominant in his second season. His three-point stroke is significantly more polished than it was in his rookie year. He's visibly added a ton of muscle. While RJ was a decent rookie, the 20-year-old born in Toronto made his first 8 shots from the field this season in a game against Oladipo and the Pacers, where he dropped 26, 8, and 5. I think he'll be a top candidate for the MIP award. Number 8, Mikal Bridges. Now next to one of the top point guards in the league in CP3 and a bona fide superstar in D-Book, small forward Mikal Bridges has a chance to break out into one of the top two-way players in the league with the new-look Suns. Defensively, he can guard players from the three-point line all the way through to the paint, as even though he's only 6'6", Mikal's long strides and 7'1 wingspan give him lockdown potential. Meanwhile, he's most effective on the other end with his ability to space the floor with an annually improving jump shot from deep. So, you could be looking at one of the better 3-and-D players for the next decade in Mikal Bridges. Number 7, Markelle Fultz. By dropping a career-high 26 points to dominate the Wizards, and by averaging nearly 22 points and 5 assists so far, the 2017 number 1 pick is in the midst of reversing his bust reputation and has fueled Orlando to a 3-0 record. Fultz looks like a new player with his poise in the pick and roll, as he even pulled up for a couple threes in the first half of his last game. Even if his once-memed shooting trigger doesn't stay consistent, Markel's long strides and elite touch at the basket make him a potentially premier slasher in the future. You can't forget, Fultz is still 22 years old, so if his points per game vamps from 12 in his third year to around 19 in his fourth, we could be watching highlights of a top MIP candidate. Number 6, Chris Boucher. With his all-star teammate and former most improved player Pascal Siakam mightily struggling with his confidence and all-around game, the slim duck Chris Boucher is looking seriously developed in 2020. Boucher swatted a career-high 7 blocks on Saturday night and also dropped 22-10 in under 30 minutes. With an elusive, high-arcing trigger from distance, in Chris, Toronto has a potentially elite stretch big on their hands. Boucher's wingspan, focused mentality, and polished shooting make the sky the limit for the undrafted 27-year-old in his fourth season, and given Toronto lost both their centers this offseason in Gasol and Ibaka to the LA teams, Boucher's going to be counted on consistently as the backup 5 for the Raptors. Number 5, Ja Morant. After how he's shown out so far, it's quite possible that the 2020 ROI becomes the 2021 MIP. As a sophomore, Ja seems to have a newfound comfort level competing against the best talent in the world. Morant dropped 44 points in his first game this year against the Spurs, and I think Morant's about to break out and make the jump into an all-star. The 21-year-old's vamped playmaking awareness in year two, combined with his explosiveness, is all proving that he'll be around as a superstar for the next decade. Number 4, Michael Porter Jr. Denver has a top 5 duo in the league in Murray and Jokic, but if they're serious about making any type of playoff run this year, MPJ must establish himself as the team's true third option. After the number 2 ranked high school basketball prospect in 2017 injured his back at Missouri, the Nuggets were able to steal Porter Jr. with the 14th selection in the 2018 draft. He missed the entirety of 2018-19 with that spine injury, and then last year, in limited minutes, put up an efficient 9 points per game. But in 2020-21, whether he plays the 3 or 4 spot, you can expect Michael's shot creating and exceptional defensive perception for his size to take a massive leap. Number 3, Darius Garland. His backcourt partner Colin Sexton was a 20-point scorer last year, but you could argue he should be on this list too. But because Darius Garland looks like a completely different player than he did in his first year, he represents the Cavaliers on this list. Garland was the 5th pick in 2019 and was expected to have a Damian Lillard-type impact, but instead his production was pretty underwhelming. But like a ton of sophomores in the league right now, he's proving how valuable having a year of NBA experience under your belt can be, as he's averaged 19 points, 8 dimes, and 2 steals in his first 3 games. While he's got an improved touch on his jumper, plus his speed and handles more overpowering this year, it's Garland's passing that's most impressed me. And with an elite scorer in the making and Colin Sexton next to him, Garland's ability to thread the needle and make Rondo-esque passes could put Cleveland in the playoff race. Number 2, Zion Williamson. Last year's number 1 pick put up a beastly 32-14 under the bright lights of Christmas Day. Everything from the decision-making to the efficiency to the explosiveness that Zion showed off so far this season should prove to you that he's about to live up to the hype big time. Zion rarely takes low percentage shots, as he knows the areas of the floor where he's dominant, and he gets positioned down low at will. That leads him to stuff stat sheets effortlessly. Luckily, he's on my fantasy team, but it's clear Zion's put in a ton of work this offseason. He's visibly added a ton of muscle and has polished his dribbling ability into his drives, leading those takes to the basket to be significantly more unstoppable than they were in his rookie year. He may not have the playmaking to be compared to LeBron, but Williamson's a dominant force in his own right, and he's on the rise at just 20 years of age. But between Zion and the next player you'll see in this non-ranked prediction list, it's really tough to decide who's most likely to win the MIP award. Before number 1, honorable mentions to Colin Sexton, Cam Johnson, Lauri Markkanen, Dante DiVincenzo, and Lonzo Ball. Number 1, Christian Wood. There were clear signs when he was with the Pistons last year that Christian Wood was about to make a name for himself as a star in the NBA. Andre Drummond was traded, and Wood averaged about 22-10 on an impressive shooting line for the rest of the season. An undrafted rookie out of UNLV, Wood bounced around the league until the Pistons signed him off waivers last season. Houston then signed him to a 3-year, $41 million deal this offseason, and now he's dominating next to James Harden, and Wood's giving one of the best scorers in league history an extremely elite outlet in pick-and-roll scenarios. Whether he rolls to the rim with abandon, or stretches the defense by popping to the 3-point line, Christian is a special asset and a much-needed commodity for a Rockets team that's desperately needed a versatile big like him for a while. This reminds me of Kobe almost getting traded in 2007 and the Lakers trading for Pau Gasol. Because in Wood's debut with the Rockets, he already topped their previous center Clint Capella's career high in scoring by dropping 31 points and grabbing 13 boards. Wood only averaged 13 points per game in total last season, so if I had to choose someone, I think he's most likely to win the award, given how overpowering his scoring can be from anywhere. But for next video shoutout, let me know who you think is most likely to win MIP in 2021. Catch up on my recent uploads. I just ranked the top 10 shooting guards, so go see if you agree with that list. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter @DFlowHoops to be friends. But this was D-Flow, and I'll see you next video.